Hi, Pastor Bill, Bethel Lutheran Church in Green Valley. Today is the 3rd of November. It is a Tuesday. Please pray with me. Dear Lord, we do trust in your unfailing love, in your promises. We give our days and all that they hold to you. May we walk in your goodness, knowing your gentle hand will guide us and keep us. Amen. Our reading for today is from the book of Romans, the first chapter, verses 20 through 23. Translation is The Message. Open your eyes and there it is. By taking a long and thoughtful look at what God has created, people have always been able to see what their eyes, as such, can't see. Eternal power, for instance, and the mystery of his divine being. So nobody has a good excuse. What happened was this. People knew God perfectly well, but when they didn't treat him like God, refusing to worship him, they trivialized themselves into silliness and confusion, so that there was neither sense nor direction left in their lives. They pretended to know it all, but were illiterate regarding life. They traded the glory of God, who holds the whole world in his hands, for cheap figurines you can buy at any roadside. Here ends our reading.
Forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. And I'm alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted. You were condemned. I'm alive and well. Your spirit is within me because you died and rose again.
like to look at a portion of our reading today, which I think is rather important. In part, it reads, "They trivialized themselves into silliness and confusion, so that there was neither sense nor direction left in their lives." All of us are guilty, at one time or another, of treating our faith, I believe, with a sense of silliness and confusion. It's when we are drawn away from God because of our sinfulness. It's when we become arrogant and we think that we can do things our way, they're the best way, and we are drawn away from God rather than being in good relationship with God because of His Spirit in our lives. Certainly, sinfulness does not allow us to remain perfectly in sync with God in all of our days. But we need to be vigilant in understanding that to be in league with God, to have God's Spirit in our lives, and to follow the path of Jesus means to give our life over to Christ with the understanding, yes, there will be those moments in our days when we fall, when we fail. But God's Spirit calls us to faithfulness. God's Spirit makes us resolute. God's Spirit, in the words of Luther, causes us to be simultaneously saint and sinner. And that makes us, day in and day out, keep after our scripture reading and our prayer life. Heed the word of God. Know always that Christ pursues you with a great passion. Amen. We close with a prayer that's been taught to us long ago. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God protect you and keep you always. Amen.